before. These two teams have played tough ball games with each other historically. And they've had four overtimes. There's an alley-oop to Michael, and he stuffs it in with a right hand. Jacobson with the alley-oop pass.
Now two on two, Gibbons and Hansel. The give to Gibbons. Oh, what a block by Anders.
Well, why not? He may not. Why not?
6 for 6. Hey, let it go.
Feeds it to Earl Clark, left wing. Clark dribbles, drives all the way. Double clutch, reverse layup, good for Clark off glass.
Wait, welcome back, Joel Myers, along with Rolando Blackman, Woliczko. Great position, capitalizes it, and earns a trip to the line.
Anders has it way out with 8 seconds, 7-6, goes all the way, left hand shot, good. Hanging in the air, Corey Anders in the key with a left hand. Jason Williams dribble drives, spins, whirls, and scores.
On your mark, ready, set, let's go. Dance floor pro, I know, you know. I go psycho when my new joint hit. Just can't sit, gotta get jiggy with it. Ooh, that's it, now honey, honey, come ride. TKNY, all up in my eyes. You got a rider, bag with a lot of stuff in it. Give it to your friend, let's spin. Everybody looking at me, glancing a kid. Wishing they was dancing a jig here with this handsome kid. Sick a cigar right from Cuba Cuba. Just bite it, it's for the look, I don't light it. Little way to AMA on the hand, stay on play. Give it up, jiggy, make it feel like four play. Yo, my cardio is infinite. Big Willie style's all in it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. What? You on the ball with the kid? Watch your step, you might fall trying to do what I did. Mama, I'ma come close side in the middle of the club with the rubber dub. No love for the haters mad cause I got floor seats at the Lakers. See me on the 50-yard line with the Raiders. Met Ali, he told me I'm the greatest. I got the fever for the flavor of a crowd pleaser. DJ play another from the prince of this, your highness. Only bad chicks riding my whip. South to the west, to the east, to the north. Bump my hips and watch them go off, but go off. Yes, yes, sure, you don't stop. Woo! In the winter order.
Summertime.
I makes it high, getting jiggy with them. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. 850 I
get in there, let's get on guard people now. Let's go on guard people.
Let's go, fellas.
Barry, you can run some blacks and orange. Pass the ball.
Yeah. And Mike, see the black. You can set that up. Okay?
Dribble up.
Right now. Let's go. Okay. One, two, three, together.
The 1997-98 season was another tremendous year for head coach Bob Thomason and the University of Pacific. Led by the conference player of the year, center Michael Olowokandi, the Tigers captured their second straight Big West Division title and returned to postseason play also for their second straight year. Starting with a sellout for Midnight Madness, Tiger enthusiasm carried UOP fans and fanatics all the way through the postseason. It was a campaign marked by five national appearances on ESPN and sellout crowds at the Spano Center that rocked basketball fans across the country. Along the way, the Tigers drilled the 21st ranked team in the nation, Fresno State, and at times were up by as many as 24 points over the WAC Bulldogs. The season was also highlighted by victories over Wisconsin in the Big Island Invitational. And in the same week, the Tigers knocked off two West Coast Conference schools by first drilling Pepperdine 78-65 and then coming right back to put the hammer on St. Mary's 90-84 on ESPN. The Tigers also set a new all-time single season attendance record while also rolling up a 16-game winning streak for the second straight year. Under Coach Thomason, the Tigers played on ESPN for the Big West Conference Championship for the second straight season. Playing one of the toughest schedules on the West Coast, the Tigers came within an eyelash of knocking off Stanford, a Final Four team, on the road in Palo Alto. Michael Olowokandi made his presence felt on the national scene and would go on to become the number one selection in the NBA draft by the Los Angeles Clippers. From the NCAAs to the NIT, the Tigers have become one of the hottest tickets in the country and a basketball power on the horizon.
Thomason at 22 feet, feeds it to Jacobson. Jake looks to post up to Michael, gets it to Michael, and he jams it. Steve Fleming got there.
Michael Olowokandi emerged to become the best center in the country while averaging 22 points a game and ripping down 11 boards a contest. Selected as the AP Honorable Mention All-American, the Candy Man was named Player of the Week five times in the Big West, breaking the record formerly held by the New York Knicks' Larry Johnson. A John Wooden Award finalist candidate, number 55 was also named to the Big West tourney team. Michael really became a force in his junior year when the Tigers knocked off Georgetown. He continued to improve through excellent coaching, and it was an NBA coming out party when he dominated Stanford's Tim Young his senior season. The single season a career leader in blocked shots, Michael also led the Tigers in points scored with 723 points. A graduate with a degree in economics and the NBA's number one selection, Olowokandi has come to epitomize what it means to play for Coach Bob Thomason and the Pacific Tigers. Senior guard Adam Jacobson had a remarkable career at Pacific in 5 years. He made a tremendous comeback following a serious knee injury to lead the Tigers. A career leader in trays with 311 three-pointers, Adam was a 39% career shooter from long distance. On the year, he shot an outstanding 40% from three-point territory. Named second-team All-Conference, number 21 is the all-time career leader in assists with 436. Adam also was the all-time career leader in games played with 120 and second all-time in steals. One of 10 players in graduate school to play Division I with a GPA of 3.5, he completed his master's over the summer. The consummate team leader who led by example and hard work, Adam is slated to play in Europe next year and hopes to return and coach in the future. Senior Corey Anders, the co-MVP in the Big West Conference tourney in 1997, struggled through an early season knee injury to come back and score 25 against UC Irvine. An honorable mention all-conference player, despite missing 10 games, Corey played in over 100 games as a Tiger and is the all-time career leader in steals at UOP. One of the most tenacious defenders and best athletes ever to play at Pacific, Anders was widely recognized as the best defender in the Big West Conference. Corey graduated this summer and will also continue playing hoops professionally. Senior Ray Mahaffey is another five-year player at UOP. A two-time honorable mention all-conference player, Rain had the ability to score inside or outside with one of the sweetest fadeaway jumpers in college basketball. Mahaffey played in 117 games as a Tiger, second all-time for Pacific. He ranked sixth all-time in field goal percentage from three-point range with an impressive 38%. Rain had the ability to step up in big games and light it up. A graduate in sports management this year, Mahaffey will continue to play professionally.
Getting an opportunity to start off the man-to-man defense. Both of these teams, excellent defensive teams.
There's Woliczko hitting another three. I mentioned what he did last night.
Senior forward Aaron Woliczko was a team leader who won championships at all three levels of play, from high school, junior college, and Division I. Aaron played with reckless abandon, sacrificing his body for the team. It wasn't surprising that he played with a broken hand for 2 months. Mr. Blue Cross also shot 46% from three-point territory in conference play. Woliczko graduated in May 1997 and spent the past season completing his teaching credential and starting on his master's. You can look for Aaron to become a coach in the future or at least perform in Mountain Dew commercials. 6'9 senior center Nick Foster was an outstanding athlete who came to play and worked very hard. Foster added depth and was another big banger coming off the bench. Foster graduated in May 1998 with a degree in accounting and a 3.2 GPA. Foster was a Big West Scholar athlete and plans to return and pursue his master's. 6'7 junior forward Jason Williams is a former Northern California Junior College Player of the Year, and there are high expectations for Jason to lead the Tigers this coming season. Williams had a great game against Fresno State in the NIT with 19 points. A high-flying offensive rebounder, with continued improvement, he will become one of the marquee players in the Big West Conference. Third on the Tigers in scoring and second in rebounding, Jason has the ability to lead the Tigers to another Big West Conference title. Number three, sophomore guard Scott Thomason, is another athlete who paid the price in the offseason, working out and lifting weights to become a better player. Scott has the ability to hit the open J, but even more importantly this past season, his work in the backcourt took the pressure off the point for the Tigers. With his ability to play the point guard position and deliver the ball inside, Thomason was a steadying influence on Pacific. The Tigers will continue to look for leadership from 6'7 forward Barry Marvel this coming season. His improvement, beginning with his freshman season, has been amazing. Marvel's had to overcome injuries, yet he has continued to refine his game each year. Barry has been an excellent teammate who shares his enthusiasm, his confidence, and his unselfish style of play that have made the Tigers winners. Sophomore point guard Earl Clark is a very solid defender and also an excellent athlete. Number 10 had a good assist-to-turnover ratio and was able to dish out 80 assists for the Tigers this past season. Clark will be one of the cornerstones to build the Tigers around and keep them atop the Big West Conference. A great kid who has the ability to become also a great leader. Earl started half the ball games at point guard for the Tigers in 98. Junior guard Clay McKnight had his left shoulder dislocated 5 different times, and 5 times he was back in the lineup. McKnight was forced to play in pain for most of the season, but he continued to demonstrate toughness and discipline that was the hallmark of the 98 Tigers. A great competitor, McKnight will be one of the players that the Pacific coaching staff will be looking to this coming season. His ability to hit the tray is another weapon in the Tiger arsenal. McKnight lit up Cal State Fullerton, going for 20 points against the Titans. Overall, Clay shot 46% from three-point territory during the season. The coaches are looking for Bill Walton to play small forward or big guard this coming year. A sharp-shooting three-point athlete, the 6'5", 205-pound redshirt freshman provided extra firepower coming off the bench. Three redshirt freshmen will also be battling for minutes during the upcoming season. Nathan Davis, a 6'1", 200-pound guard, 6'10", 260-pound center Ross Mills, and Eli Kadrowski, a 6'6", 220-pound small forward. Along with an excellent recruiting class, rated 45th in the nation by Hoop Scoop magazine, 5 of those athletes were honorable mention All-Americans. Mike Hahn, Mike Preston, and Dan Masters, all from Nebraska, Matt and Andy Abernathy from Indiana, and Tim Johnson from Oregon.
Hey, Richardson, number 1.
Richardson wins for 22. See what I'm saying? How much is that?
Come on, let's go. Five, you got to take it, and then Barry go to the basket and match up whoever is down there. Okay? Just hustle your tail on the guy. Rebound to Zoom.
Rebound. Once it's good to go.
Rebound down.
The key to Pacific success has been head coach Bob Thomason and his outstanding staff. Thomason is widely recognized in the coaching community as one of the top head coaches in the nation. An educator and a man of integrity, Coach Thomason, along with Tony Markopoulos, Ron Verlin, and the newest assistant coach Monty Owens, a member of Pacific's 1997 NCAA team, all have the Tigers geared for a return to the big dance.
Here's Anders to Jake, looks inside, Michael O stops it with a right hand as he went ferociously charged into the bucket. Hit the 10.
Hey!
And if you choose to play a Pacific, this is what could happen to you.
With the first pick in the 1998 NBA draft, the Los Angeles Clippers select Michael Olowokandi from University of Pacific. Michael Olowokandi, you talk about the inexperience factor, you talk about where this kid came out of nowhere. Here's his situation. The son of a Nigerian diplomat living in London, 7 feet tall, a great athlete, trying to decide, hey, I'd like to kind of tinker with this basketball thing. Picks up a guide to U.S. colleges, looks at the letter P, University of the Pacific, I'll call them. He calls, an assistant coach answers, and he said, I'd like to play basketball, I'm 7 feet tall. Coach says, we don't have any scholarships. He said, not a problem, I'll pay my own way. He comes over, and the coach figures, he said, well, you know, if he's 7 feet tall and he can't play, it's all right, we got a 7 foot student on campus. If he can play, we got a big thing going on here. It's happened for Michael Olowokandi, the Candy Man, as they call him. What a story, Hubie.